The purpose of Senior Design Project is basically our students' entire undergraduate life, they've been studying engineering. And now they have the opportunity to form a team and come up with an idea of their own. And then they have to build it, of course, and test it, and then present it at the expo.
As long as the boom is right, you can literally do whatever you want. You take one snapshot, you're done with the calibration.
Yeah, that's fine.
So we could just do that. Just buy like marketing.
An engineer is a person who rigorously makes the world better. Any problem, we're trained to strip it down to what do I need to do to fix this. What sets engineering apart is the way that problems are the very core of what you're focusing on.
The project is to create a rapid meningitis diagnostic.
I think the most engaging part of the process for me would definitely be the solution design and the autonomy that comes with it, I would say. We really get to explore all avenues of solution and determine, oh, based on this, I think this one is the most feasible considering the environment, considering the problem.
It is really nice to get out and actually do things with your hands and then understand what it means to make things. Good?
We're clear.
Clear? The beach cleaning robot is basically our attempt to mechanize beach cleaning. And so what we're trying to do is make it autonomous and have robots do that for us.
Some people say the best way to think outside the box is to not know where the box is. I find the best students that come into the lab are students who come in with a blank slate. They haven't been told what's the right way and what's the wrong way, and then they just create wonderful new inventions.
The main focus wasn't to just create a robot that could talk with you, but a robot that could develop emotional intelligence.
Now we're getting to that phase of bringing everything together, making sure things work in conjunction, you know, making sure the neck works with the eye and does what it's supposed to.
We might not have it like fully assembled, but we'll be able to at least.
Even if you just move what you have.
We can make things move, like even the eyelids move.
Do you think that will make it move up more?
I think so.
Yeah, well, try it until it's like flat. Right.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
I like it 15
flat.
That's what I just said.
We're remaking our robotic arm picture in jet black nylon.
This is an artistic robot that's able to draw pictures. We had someone who's worked with robotic arms, and I'm in an image processing class, and I've got some algorithmic backgrounds. We basically wanted to hit on what our team can execute well. And we also wanted to do a project that sort of exists on that line between, you know, art and engineering.
The point that's particularly important to me is when the teams become really autonomous. That's when we go from being students to being young engineers. The added benefit that a Columbia engineer has is the ability to identify the problem on his or her own. And that is critical for the spirit of innovation, to be able to actually invent things. It is the thing that I think makes for a more enhanced engineer, and it speaks towards the C's mission of engineering for humanity. It's you don't engineer something apropos of nothing.